Good morning, dear students and viewers. I welcome you all in my YouTube channel, Zaid Chemistry. I am Sheikh Zohrul Islam, teacher of high school Shan. And today we are going to discuss about the next chapter from physics portion of subject science. And the name of the chapter is Magnetic Effects of Electric Current. Let's start with our topic. In this particular topic, the total marks duration of this lesson is up to 4. जो पहला चैप्टर आपका है उसमें आपके 10 मार्क्स है, दूसरे में आपकी 5 है, तीसरे में आपकी 6 है, इसमें आपकी 4 है, तो जो इसके बाद जो लास्ट वाला है उसमें भी आपकी 4 है, तो टोटल में ये 28 मार्क्स आते हैं फिजिक्स में. इस तरीके से केमिस्ट्री में 28 है, तो 28 जो है वो आपकी लाइफ साइंस में बनते हैं, तो टोटल 84 मार्क्स है. तो बाकी जो 60 मार्क्स है वो एक्चुअली आप लोगों के प्रैक्टिकल के होते हैं. तो इट इज द टोटल ड्यूरेशन ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट साइंस. Let's start with our topic. In this particular chapter, we are going to discuss about the magnetic field or magnetic effect that is basically created due to movement of electric current through any electric wire or through any solenoid or through any spiral this electric wire. And this magnetic effect or this magnetic field, it basically what it tries it it basically creates a sort of influence or it creates a sort of effect on the nearby objects. It can attract the nearby objects or it can repel the nearby objects, or sometimes it will influence the objects or it will within the same body where this magnetic field gets originated, there exerts the certain types of lines. Those lines are called as magnetic field or lines, and these magnetic field of lines, they always move in a direction of north to south. That all is to be discussed in this particular topic. Let's start with our first topic, that is magnetic field. What magnetic field is? Magnetic field is it is basically an influence. It is basically an influence, or we can state that when a current moves in a wire, it produces a field around it, and that field is called as magnetic field. Or we can state that a current in a wire produces a field around it is called as magnetic field. जब भी इलेक्ट्रिक करंट किसी भी वायर के जरिए पास होती है, किसी भी कंडक्टर के जरिए पास होती है, तो इसके आसपास एक फील्ड बनता है. उस फील्ड को हम क्या कहते हैं? दैट फील्ड इज कॉल्ड एज मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. तो ये जो मैग्नेटिक फील्ड है, इट इज रिलेटेड विद दिस मैग्नेट. मैग्नेट, व्हाट मैग्नेट इज? मैग्नेट इज बेसिकली इट इज एन ऑब्जेक्ट दैट हैज द प्रॉपर्टी टू अट्रैक्ट आयरन ऑब्जेक्ट. एक ऐसा ऑब्जेक्ट, एक ऐसी चीज, एक ऐसा ऑब्स्टेकल जो कि आयरन ऑब्जेक्ट्स को, इन्हें उन चीजों को, उन आर्टिकल्स को जो कि आयरन से बने हुए हैं, उनको ये अट्रैक्ट करता है. तो जो मैग्नेट है, मैग्नेट इज बेसिकली इट इज नेचुरल एज वेल एज मैन मेड. तो हमारे पास जो आज मैग्नेट है, ये एक्चुअली नेचुरल भी है, ये मैन मेड भी है. और लेबोरेटरी में जो हमारे पास जो मैग्नेट है, दे आर मैन मेड. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, अगर हम देखेंगे जो नेचुरल मैग्नेट है, दैट इज द ओर ऑफ द आयरन, दैट्स कॉल्ड इज मैग्नेटाइट ओर. तो जो मैग्नेटाइट ओर है, दैट ओर इज यूजुअली प्रेजेंट इन अर्थस क्रस्ट, एंड इट वॉज बेसिकली शिफर्ड वॉज दियर, एंड वेन दिस शिफर्ड ही वॉज एक्चुअली ग्रेजिंग हिज कैटल्स, ही फाइंड सर्टन सॉर्ट ऑफ अट्रैक्शन by the earth, because his shoes they were made up of iron, and then he called that there is something, there's some substance which is attracting these iron objects, and that particular substance was called as magnet. Kyunki jo ye banda tha, ye his name was related with this magnet. That is why ki fir magnet ka naam bhi actually kya pada? Magnet hi pada. To hamare paas actually jo magnet, it is basically a एक कहानी सी है ये. अलबत्त जो हमारे पास, हम तो वहां पे गए नहीं हैं, अगर जो हमारे पास जो मैग्नेट है, जो कि जिनका कि हम लेबोरेटरी में ऑब्जर्व कर सकते हैं, तो हम उन मैग्नेट्स के बारे में पढ़ेंगे जिनको हम मैन मैग्नेट भी कहते हैं. तो जो मैग्नेट है, दीज मैग्नेट्स ऑफ डिफरेंट शेप्स एंड डिफरेंट साइजेस. फॉर एग्जाम्पल एक मैग्नेट है जिसको हम बार मैग्नेट कहते हैं. दिस बार मैग्नेट इट हैज टू पोल्स, वन इज नॉर्थ पोल एंड अनदर इज साउथ पोल. एंड दिस बार मैग्नेट इट ऑलवेज अलाइंस इटसेल्फ, इट ऑलवेज अलाइंस इटसेल्फ इन द अर्थस मैग्नेट फील्ड. जो मैग्नेट है अर्थ का जो मैग्नेट फील्ड इट इज इन द नॉर्थ साउथ डायरेक्शन. एंड दिस मैग्नेट ऑल्सो अलाइंस इटसेल्फ इन द नॉर्थ साउथ डायरेक्शन इफ वी विल ट्राई टू सस्पेंड इट बाय द हेल्प ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. देन देयर इज हॉरोशू मैग्नेट, अ मैग्नेट दैट इज नॉट द शेप ऑफ द हॉरोशू. And then there is cylindrical magnet. This is also a magnet which is man-made magnet. And these magnets, they are always, they present, they remain always in the direction of Earth's magnetic field. That means north-south direction. And these magnets have two poles. One is north pole and another south pole. Like poles, they repel each other. If we will try to make like poles, when we will try to make like poles to come to each other, they will not come. Come near each other, they will try to repel each other. Or we can say that like poles repel each other and unlike poles they attract each other. It means north and north pole will repel each other, south and south pole repel each other. However, north will attract to south and south will attract to north pole. And that is why this bar magnet or these magnet, they align itself in the earth's magnetic field, that is north south direction. What this magnet? Whenever we will put this magnet on any object, or we will suspend this magnet with the help of string, this magnet have a space around it. It has a space around it up to which it can exert magnetic force. It can try to attract other magnet, or it will try to attract other objects that, or it will try to influence other objects which are present nearby to this magnet. That particular space around this magnet up to which it can exert this magnetic force is called as magnetic field. A space around a magnet up to which it can exert its magnetic force is called as magnetic field. This magnetic field is always present in the north south direction. And these magnetic field, there occurs certain sort of lines. Although it seems that these lines are hypothetical lines, but we can represent them with the help of lines, or their exert certain sort of lines. These lines actually, they are drawn in the magnetic field. They are drawn in the magnetic field along which the north magnetic pole would move. Or we can say that the nature of or the extent of this magnetic field is shown by certain lines. These lines always start from the north pole and they tend to move towards this south pole. And these magnetic lines of force, they actually show us the intensity or the extent of any magnetic field created by a magnet. And these lines, they are drawn in the magnetic field created by a magnet along which a north magnetic pole would move. Or we can state that these lines are drawn in a magnetic field created by a magnet and are always pointed in the north south direction. At the poles, means north and south, these magnetic lines of force are very much close to each other, while as in the middle, these lines are farther away from each other. It means that at the poles, the extent of magnetic field is very much strong. That was all about today's topic. Have a nice day.